to another live stream and maybe another YouTube video, depending on, you know, if this live stream is good or not. I just want to start off really quickly by making a couple of sounds because I tried to stream yesterday and Okay, so I'm gonna start off making a couple sounds and stuff like that to kind of get started already on a drop, because last time I didn't do a drop right away and it was really weird. Like, I was so picky about the melody and stuff like that, and I think a melody should come secondary to the drop. Like, I've been like working a lot on drops on other tracks as well recently, so that's pretty cool. Oh man, you can get some weird sounds with M-talk. Let's see. I love Massive for that. Massive is pretty cool. Yeah. Actually, I'm gonna do something right now, just right now, alright? I'm gonna set this up so that every time I load a new Massive, this thing is already set up like that. That's gonna be so freaking useful. Okay, add to plugin database. I'm not sure which one. Okay, probably send classic. Yeah, it's in there. Perfect. All right. So, is there only one Massive? Let's see if that worked. Hope it did. See? Yep. It did work. Finally. Should probably do the same for Serum. Actually, that'd be really useful. It's just to make sure I don't have to do this like every time I load the plugin in or anything. So. Crap. Hold on, I have to resize my screen there. Okay. Hopefully that didn't change the stream too much. Okay. And what I'm going to do is load up basic shapes right away. I'll still put it on saw, but just have the basic shapes already kind of there. I'm pretty sure this is saw. Yeah. Perfect. So I'll add that. This can be our default sort of preset now. So yeah, there you go. Finally. Now we don't have to do this every time. Okay, now we're gonna mess with this frequency shifter. Try to get some real weird stuff, I guess. Let's see, routing. Let's see. Yeah, this is really cool. Alright. Let's add some filtering onto that stuff here. Really weird. See, I'll just keep messing with some filters here and then might add another oscillator perhaps. Maybe mess with that a little bit as well, right here. Hey, what's up, Hazyok? Welcome to the stream, man. Alright, I'll add a couple more voices on this. Maybe alternate between filters. Yeah, that's a really cool sound. I actually like that. M-talk, F-shifter. And it's gonna be a bass here, so yeah. We're pretty much just starting off, you know, making a couple cool sounds, I guess, and see, you know, just to see what we can get here. So I'm gonna record that. Just to see if we can get any, like, cool lead sounds using this specific wavetable. So yeah, okay, this is a G right here, so yeah, just put that right in serum here. Okay, yeah, there's probably some cool stuff we can do with that, so. Maybe we could make a growl or something using that, even though this is technically a growl. I don't know. Okay, let's see, I'm actually gonna FM a little bit, so. We have our basic shapes here. Do FM from A. Alright, that I don't hear anything. Let's do this. Okay, I'll do this actually. Alright. Yeah, that thing is so useful how I set this up already. Alright, this is not too bad. Let's see. Oh, I messed it up. Oh my god, really? Let's fix it. Sorry about that. That's a little bit weird. Oh man, that is so weird. Oh man, why is Serum doing that? It's so weird. Hold on. Try detaching and reattaching. What the hell is going on? I'm actually in Serum right now. You guys can't see it? Man, I'm actually so rattled right now. Hold on. I think I might know how to fix that. I'll just do a window capture instead. So just one moment, I'll try to fix it. Here you go. And then I'll have add. Sorry about that. So monitor capture one. Okay. Oh, now that's on top of everything. At least you can see it now, I mean. Okay, so I'll move that down. Alright, and I'll edit scene here. This must be so awkward for you guys right now, but whatever. OBS window setup, oh yeah. Alright, so that should be good. I mean, it's better than the other thing we had earlier, so. Alright. Yeah, there you go, sorry about that, man. Interesting, but hey, yeah, thanks, Hazok. I appreciate that. This is really cool. I might just add a couple filters on top of that, and maybe we could make a kind of penguin lead type of thing. That'd be pretty awesome. This is just, what is HB anyway? Oh, high pass and band pass. Okay, that's a little weird for a filter there. Hey, what's up, Just Streaming and L? Welcome to stream. This is a really interesting sound, actually. I actually kind of like that. Let's go with add a little bit of noise here. Okay, maybe a little distortion. Could kind of mix that in a little bit. Alright, that's not too bad. Let's go add some depth and frequency here. Alright, then compressor on top of that, and then we'll do like last EQ and filter. Then that should be a good sound. Yeah. I might do a negative peaking there. That could be interesting here. So then I'll do that. Sounds like a yo-yo sound, but okay. Then that last high pass on top of there, so I'll get a HP 12 with the resonance. That's actually pretty cool. Okay, so far we have this. A little bit weird. M-talk growl thing, I guess. I do want to make another growl using that this sound right here. So, let's see, what note is that again? Let's hear it. It's a G, I'm pretty sure. Yep, perfect. We're gonna make a growl sound with that. Just by importing that, let's do that. This. Okay. And then bending plus minus. Okay, trigger. Let's see. We need a nice position here. Okay, that's. This could make a unique growl, actually. Yeah, let's go add on to this, actually. So, I might have NHB from earlier was really cool. You can get some really cool effects with that, so I might do that again. So, HB will get the frequency here. Freaking god, the serum is so powerful in conjunction with massive. Yeah, that is true. It's pretty much, I guess they're kind of very similar, but I think serum is kind of superior to it in terms of editing wavetables and stuff like that. So let's go add a phaser maybe on here. All right. Okay, yeah, the multiband didn't do a horrible job here. That's pretty good. I'll do a peaking here. That might be a little bit much. Okay, and then I'll do a negative over here. Nice. Then a HP right here, high pass peak. All right, let's get that frequency up a little bit. Yeah, that's pretty cool. The only thing is that it's a lot of low end for this type of growl. Okay, maybe a little bit of noise. Let's go, I might do white noise. Alright, that's really cool. I kind of like that. So this can be our main growl. I would really want to make this like unique, so probably going to be boosting this high right here, and maybe multi-band compression and stuff like that. Oh damn, that phaser is actually has a huge release. Okay, that might be a little bit of noise here. Let's see, I'll leave it at like 3%. That way it's still there, but like it's not as overtaking, I guess. Okay, let's. Okay, I really like this growl, actually. I don't know if we should keep the vocoder on or not. Let's hear it without again. Nah, screw the vocoder. It's already like weird enough as is. I'll maybe add a lo-fi in here. That could. That doesn't do a horrible job. Some reverb on top of that. Okay. Nice. Okay, that's a good growl right there. Let's see. We'll make a couple squeaky sounds. Like I should not call them that at all, but like just squarey type of stuffs. So probably have. I'll do an envelope for this. So probably gonna do some FMing here. We'll see. Okay, so I'll do that on here too, and then let's see. No, we might not do exactly that. Let's see. I'll find a cool position to start the oscillation at. So. That's pretty cool. Might add some more stuff on top of here, like. Okay, that could be really weird, but I don't know. We'll try something. Okay, I'll pass. Maybe that could work. Let's see. LFO on here. Hold on, you can actually do this this cool thing with reverb right here. It's kind of like the reverb filter in there. Let's see what the. Let's see. Can I try to make house? I have made house in the past. It's not as fun, that's the thing. Like I could try to make a kind of house melody if you want later, but. Let's see, put that drive down a little bit. Oh, damn, that sine shaper. That's so cool. Let's see, I'll do this. Nope. Pretty cool. I might add one last filter over here, just a bandpass. Yeah, I like that. That's really cool. Making sounds. Alright, that is pretty cool. I can we'll do melody and then we'll try house later if you'd like. So yeah. I just want a good chord progression. We don't have to do our like melody right away, but yeah. I really want to do that typical melody, type of thing. That's actually a really interesting melody. So, or chord progression, so yeah. That could be interesting. Let's see. I really have to fix up the chords here. Hey, thanks for the follow, official DJ. Okay, yeah, I might just do this last chord like that. Yeah, that's a sick chord progression right there. Oh, you just came from my videos on YouTube. Wow, thanks for checking that out also. That's freaking awesome. Let's see. I'm gonna have my, usual default drum set or whatever right here. All right. And yeah, just get a usual drum pattern here. Just kick, snare, that kind of thing. No. That's pretty cool. I'll get a unique hat or something like that, maybe change things up a little bit from the usual, because usually I just have like my default, I call everything default even though it's not, but I usually have my BHK hats and that kind of thing, so I'll just try to get like weird vengeance hats or whatever. Let's see. Yeah, okay. Okay, I could probably deal with that one. That one's not too bad. Let's see. Okay. Is that even it right there? It's after the cymbals and stuff, so it's up here. Let's go with like a I might have to alternate between like hats and stuff a bit. Okay. Okay, maybe something like that. Okay, I'll have a white noise hat right here, so this one. That's actually pretty swag. That's a nice little beat right there. Okay, so we'll make sure to keep this right here. I'll copy the pattern, and I'm gonna get a daft in here. So like, I like to call these daft, but in reality, they're just a low pass chords, pretty much. It just seems as if the daft filter is a little bit smoother than the low pass, but that might just be me. I don't know, not exactly sure. Let's see. Oh yeah, that's way too low. Okay, so there you go. Okay. Now what I'm gonna do is, okay, yeah, that's a little fast. Let's see. Probably this right here, just like that. Nice. I've actually never heard a chord progression go exactly like that, so that's a good sign, I guess. Might have to go a little lower on these ones right here. Definitely digging that. I'll sidechain that, quick things, pretty much everything. Alright, there you go. Let's see. I'm really unsure as to what to use for the bass. So one thing I could use is one of my bass samples that I just like one shot, pretty much, and that could work, so hold on. So I'll edit that in Edison real fast. Just, you know, cut that out. Alright, nice little sample right there. So that should be good. If we make a pattern, I need to make the envelope here. So no attack, short release. I'll let the decay like that. That should be good. Okay, I might need to fine-tune that actually, so. Yeah, that should be good. Okay. Let's see. Huh. It just sounded off because it was lower, but All right, I think we need an ARP in here at this point. Just a simple ARP. I don't know why I opened MiniSynth. That's like the most random freaking plugin ever. Isn't that even for FL Mobile? I think it is. If it's not, I'm totally like shitting on it for nothing, but. So probably something like that will do the ARP here. I love the ARP function in here because pretty much does it for you. As you can see, that's a kind of weird chords. I might get the actual chord progression. That could be interesting. Let's see. That's a bit high right here, so maybe. Really want to make something unique though for this, so we'll kind of make something using bandpasses and saws just to try to get something unique. Yeah. I'll get a quick attack here on the filter. Maybe on here as well. Yeah, that could be unique. Yeah, a little vibe. Oh. That's actually pretty unique. You have to turn it down a lot, but that's. Might be a little fast though, but I mean, whatever. I might just keep it at three notes so that it kind of. So sick. Okay, this is like 2/3, so it still works fine, I think. Let's try putting that a little higher. Actually, yeah, it's 2/3. So maybe a bit higher. I screwed up somewhere here. Yeah, that was really bad. It's supposed to be an E. Nope, it's, oh my god. It's supposed to be a F sharp. Alright, so let's focus on our bass pattern right now. Okay, I'm gonna get a really cool harmonic bass down here. So. Pretty much something like that. I'll do restart via gate, and I'll also get this envelope. Yeah, that should be okay, I guess. Let's try that. Okay, so it was on a F sharp. Maybe lower, actually. Good bass track, I'd say. Maybe we could do something, make it a little more unique here with a sample and hold. That did not do anything. Route. Ooh. Maybe that little vibrato on there. Okay. Stereo imaging here, technically. Okay, let's try that. Let's hear it. There's no sidechain. That is a little bit annoying. We'll hear it after I'm done the sidechain, because, like, yeah, it's super important to have sidechain in here. There's the ghost note there. Alright. Let's go like that. Bang, bang, bang. I have to pretty much put a sidechain trigger every time there's a kick and snare, so right here, here, pretty much everywhere. Then just repeat, because it's the same pattern over there, so okay. Next thing, volume shaper here, like that, port 20. And just a small kind of sidechain deal here. There you go, MIDI one shot. And that should work. Yeah, works. It's a little bit much right now. Ah, that's why. This isn't getting sidechained, and it's not even in a track, so. Okay. There's a little delay there on the kick and snare, but I'll adjust it really quickly here. It's like super short, it's not even like relevant, but whatever. There we go, that should work. Let's hear that. I'll just turn this down and turn the ARP down a little bit, so maybe compress that a little bit, because Well, I just opened Ozone. That's not too good. Alright, stream is still working fine, so that is very surprising. Okay, maybe like that. And this hat, I'm actually going to have go through the sidechain. So second track here. And I'll have a reverb on here. I'll let the high cut and high damping all the way up, and yeah, do that kind of thing. I'll just compress those hats a little bit. Alright, that's pretty good. I think we can get rid of the metronome now. See, we gotta do a little bit of mixing here. What is that? Bass sample. Sidechain U. Okay. Yeah, it's a little bit tough. We don't have a very long kick, so... Or, it's not long because it's been compressed here, so... Let's take off... Maybe change the compression here. That... Let's see. Maybe something like that, let's hear it. I might get a different... hold on, let's try repitching that. Just one down or one up, something like that. I'll turn everything down a little bit. That's a little bit much. Ooh, still haven't fixed this bass part yet, so let's do that. Crap. Alright, there you go. That's pretty much the chord progression, so just have that kind of play like that. Okay. Yeah, let's name this quick things. ARP 1. Hey, do you give viewers feedback on their tracks? Yeah, sometimes. I haven't done it on stream in a long time, and it's usually, I usually don't do it on bigger streams when there's a lot of people, because, you know, people don't really want to watch that, but yeah, if you want, I can check your track out. Like, I don't mind right now, to be honest. Okay, we might keep the ARP for a little bit later here. Just need some kind of breakdown here, so like... no, not vocals. Effects, probably? Just like, let's see. Let's see, right here. Okay. Let's see. Like that, right here. What is the best VST for house? I have never used a free oscillator VST, to be honest. Everything I use is pretty much paid, so I have no idea, to be honest. Okay, I'll listen to your track right now. There, Aerostorm preview. Alright, let's turn that volume down a little bit. Yeah, that's pretty cool. It's definitely pretty cool. The sub is a little bit high, I think. Unless you have two layers. I can't like hear the really deep sub bass, but yeah, it seems to be a little bit high there. And yeah, other than that, maybe get a more hard-hitting kick. That could maybe work. But other than that, it's really good. I mean, it's pretty good for the big room, I guess. Let's see. Down. Alright, let's get a nice monophone here. Yeah, anytime, hiding kicks. Alright, let's get some reverb in here. Not sure what to do here. Lead one. Okay, there you go. Create automation. Should not have done that on the whole track. Whatever. Let's put that here. What's another thing we can do? Instead of having full-time legato triller, we could just do, you know, that kind of deal. Sometimes. Ooh. That could be interesting. Let's see. We'll get something more unique here. Bandpass, what else? Maybe I never use screen filters, but that's actually really weird. That's actually really weird. What the hell? Let's see, I'll get less detuned here. And a little bit of distortion on top of that. Let's see. Okay. A little sidechain here. I'll boost the high ends on top here. Let's copy this again. I don't know what to do here. How long have you used FL Studio and how much time does it take to learn to use it? Honestly, it depends on everybody. It took me a lot longer than it should have to learn FL Studio because I take longer to learn stuff, but when I do learn it, I try to do it in depth, so I know kind of exactly what everything does and that kind of thing. So it took me to learn all of FL Studio, probably a year or something like that. And yeah, other stuff like Massive, that took me another, like, I don't know, 6 months just to learn that. Serum didn't take too long, because I was already used to Massive, so Serum maybe a month or so. So yeah. Serum is awesome, by the way. Little vibrato, I mean, little reverb and delay. Maybe not too slow. Okay, I'll do this, but like with a cut here. That's actually pretty interesting. Yeah, we can kind of keep it like low key over here and then get something that you know, takes a little bit more space in the second part. Oh, that's pretty interesting. Wow, not too bad. Can you listen to my track, bro? Sure, I'll listen to it. Quick things. Okay, is it Rum You Jump? Let's hear it. Quick things. Ah, it's pretty cool, man. Pretty cool. Holy crap, this melody is insane. Okay. Stop. hold on. Chop vocals, also. Low key saws. Let's do that right now. Let's go. So scream. Little vibrato. Little reverb. That's a lot of reverb actually. Delay. Not too much here. High shelf. There you go. Something like that. I don't know. Let's hear that. Let's rise that up as we go. So, something like that. I really want to rename this before I do that. Lead. Crap. Low key saws. So, yeah. I'll rise up macro 2. Like that. Whoops. Let's do this right here. Maybe a little more subtle and not as much. That'd be pretty cool. Okay, I'll keep that there. I was going to do chop vocals, which I never do, to be honest. That's something really weird. So, I do have some chop vocals already, but I have this like sound bank of like this girl singing. So like, hold on. I actually have a brand new freaking. Hold on one second, please. Alright, sorry about that, guys. Had a phone call there from my mom. So, yeah. Anyway, I was about to say, I have a brand new vocal pack that I got recently. It's a free vocal pack that Ava, I'm pretty sure, Ava. Pretty much A-Ray, I don't know if you guys know that guy. Probably. He pretty much shouted that pack out. And it's really cool. So, I'll just put that in my thing. That's gonna be right. Oh, hold on. I have to wait till it extracts or whatever. Is it done? Yep. Okay. There it is. So yeah, right here. There's a demo song. Okay. Hold on. What is going on? I think my headphones are weird again. Yeah, they were. Just want to get like something casual that can hop into here. Wow, she's actually not bad at all. Okay, harmony waves. Okay, I like that one. I like it a lot. Let's see. If you guys want a link to that pack, you might. Hold on, let me just find it. It's actually a Facebook post, which is funny. Ava vocal pack. Okay, so. Crap. I really want to find that. Oh! Yeah, I got it. Okay, it's right here, guys. If you want the vocal pack, it's free. So, pretty awesome. Yeah. Yeah, free pack. Awesome. I like that. So. It's in key, too. What the hell? That's hilarious. That's awesome. Fucking love that girl. I might hire her to do vocals for one of my tracks. Let's see. Do just a cut like that. No regret. Yeah, I'll re-pitch that. Just like that. Just want to auto-tune this pretty much. Not because she's not in key, just because I like the sound of auto-tune, just for some reason. Okay, fruity balance. No, what the hell am I saying? Fruity pitcher. Okay, that's a beat. Like, she's actually on key. I've bought in packs that, like, the singers aren't even on key, but this singer is freaking, like, right on. Let's see. Right here. Kind of want to have a pitch bend there. I'm not sure how I'm going to do that, though. Hold on, I know how we can do that. Check this out. We won't use autotune for this. 200. Alright, and then I'll do a like 3 semitone pitch bend. Something like this. Let's hear it. Okay. Oh damn, no. I don't know what I was thinking there. Shadow, soul, shadow, shadow. Maybe I could do something faster, but I don't know. God damn. I'm honestly impressed as hell. Okay, we'll put that on 12 as well. Now we'll link both of these tracks to, I don't know why I did two tracks actually for that. That's, whatever. We'll link both of these to our main vocal effects chain, which is gonna be right here. Hold on, that's so weird. Why the, oh my god. There you go, right here. Okay, that's our main effects chain right here. See, what can we do here? I just want to try this, okay? I'm not gonna actually, like, keep it, probably. This could be hilarious. Okay, no, let's not keep that. A little vocoder. Mod 00. A little lower here. Maybe that. Nope. Yep. A little vocoder. That's pretty freaking awesome. Okay, I'll link that to sidechain here. And we'll do a high pass here for good measure. Alright, right here. And hold on, there's one of these that isn't getting affected at all. Right here. Let's see. Okay, this I really want to like pitch up like that. So we have the 50% value here. like that. Okay, what's going on? Oh, okay, there. I kind of want to compress that a little bit because they're not the same volume. That could work. Yes, this could definitely work. Let's link that to the Vocodic stuff track. And I want to lock it into that pitch. So, pitcher right here. So that's a E right there. I want to keep it at the E. So it's going to sound a little, you know, auto-tuned, but whatever. Okay. Oh man, those are awesome. Oh man, this could be interesting. I don't know if this is a good idea to do all of them in the, you know, to do this entirely based on the vocals. But it's sick though. Like, it's gonna take a long time. There you go, like that. I'll use this part right here. Okay. This is pretty cool. Yeah. Take it down. All right. Let's hear that our other part here. See if we could actually merge them. Okay, I could definitely put little kind of vocal samples and stuff here and there. That's really cool. Okay. I won't do the vocal chop at the beginning exactly like that, because that would be for a vocal song in which you do it with the stems, so yeah, that'd be... Okay, we need to make that first melody a little bit more fluent, you know? I kind of want to make it an even more, you know, an even bigger kind of progression, but I don't know, I've never experimented in that part. Or if I have, I've screwed up, so. Okay, I might. Okay, I'll give it a try. If it doesn't work, whatever. We still have the old pattern. So, yeah. Alright, let's go. Okay, there you go. Okay, so C right here. Like that. Tyke tau. I don't know. Tan tick tick down. Yeah, that's what I do sometimes, like tan tick tick down. Yeah, you'll hear me do that sometimes. Okay, let's see. There you go, that's not too bad. Just have to change chords down here. Okay, I'll do it with the D bass. There you go, that's pretty good. Yeah, it's pretty good. Let's go. Okay, so it's gonna be on A. Oh, whoops. Wrong note. Yep, wrong note. Oops. It's there you go. Now I have no idea which note it's supposed to be on. Damn it. Okay, I guess it's still on A. There you go. May or may not have screwed up. Yep, I did. Okay. How did I screw that up? Okay. Not entirely sure how I screwed that up, but it's okay. I know exactly where this is gonna go in the song. Right after the drop, or the main weird stuff, I'm gonna have this pattern. Except that we're gonna replace the bass with a saw, a distorted saw and noise bass. So we're gonna have this right here, you know, boost a high, boost it low a little bit. So I like to call this saw, just plain and simple. And yeah, sidechain. So, hold on, let's EQ it right away. It's a bit of a ridiculous EQ, but whatever. Alright, see you later, just streaming NL. Well, see you later, I guess. And there you go, another breakdown right after that. I might do a melodic dubstep for this drop actually. Pretty used to doing kind of bro step and stuff like that, so. Okay, that's a cool kind of beginning here. Then you get some strings in here, kind of harmonize everything. There we go. How about some nice string assembly here? Alright, it's pretty awesome. Let's do that again then. We still have this arp right here. It's in that triplets pretty much though. So we'll do this. This is gonna be our kind of aid to build everything up. Thank you. Oh yeah. See if we can actually distort that even more. Before the reverb. Oh, that's a little bit much though. And then I want to do crazy, like, frequency shifter bases and all that stuff. Let's see if we can kind of work on that a little bit. So, yeah, that'd definitely be our first chord right there. Let's see. Gonna have to... Okay, drop would be right here. Okay. Drum pattern, we'll do a quick kick and snare. We'll add all the stuff later here. Just want to get this idea down, I guess. Okay, let's see. Okay. We'll add all the crashes and stuff in a second. There you go, nice little hat pattern right here. Whoops. Let's see. Hold on, just gotta reply to the text here. Alright. Let's see. We should probably get our crashes straight into the playlist, because that way it's a lot easier to manipulate like that. So I'll get this one. Probably that one. That one's alright. This as well. Maybe we can alternate between crashes and stuff. So I like to do this. Crashes. Just make one kind of track for each. For the crashes. So yeah, that's track three. Actually, I don't know. I recently stopped sidechaining a lot of like hats and stuff like that for some reason. So I don't know. I'll just see what happens here. I like cutting it short right here, and kind of doing the same thing there. You know, that kind of thing. Maybe I'll sidechain it just for now. Actually, there's no sidechain anyway, so. Okay, so let's hear that. Might compress, reverb, do all that kind of thing in a second here for the crashes. EQ as well, it's pretty important. High pass, reverb, lots, and before the reverb actually compression, so, or before the EQ as well. And hold on, I have to give that track 3 as well. There you go. That's nice. Okay. Now I need that chord, actually. So it's actually I have the chord pattern right here, so perfect. We'll make a new... No, not using meth. Using serum. Because I like the saws in here. Listen to this. Sounds so airy. Like if you layer everything in there. Look. You'll see what I mean. That's not exactly a chord, but... Let's see, just... There you go. It's a nice little chord layout already. Sorry, it just came. What is that plugin called? It sounds sexy. It's actually called Serum. And yeah, you can pretty much do this in any thing that has Unison in it. I'm pretty sure you can do it inside of here as well. It's not like as good, but you know, still does quite a good job. I like layering stuff. I don't like just having like one layer of whatever. So lots of layering in here. Alright, let's give that a track. Just have it sidechain here. I'll give the same track to this one. Saws, where is that? Right here. Alright, give that same note here. Let's see, are we gonna layer this with sub bass or a saw bass? Maybe a saw just for now. Is it B? Yep. Okay, I could deal with that for now. Now we gotta find filler sounds and stuff, so this is gonna be the kind of toughy part. Yeah, definitely gonna be tough. Okay, let's start right away. Man, I'm not exactly sure how we're gonna go about this, but yeah. We'll just use cool wavetables, I guess, and bending shapes. Okay, this isn't too bad. I just have to set this out a little. Okay. Let's see, what else? AI. Get some really growly sounds in here. Bandpass. I want to get another LFO for that bandpass we can do crazy stuff with. So we'll get, I really want to get like some weird stuff in here, so. Uh Oh, you can actually alternate between the filters here. I'll do that with the LFO here. Okay, nice, nice. So, pretty nice. I'll get the frequency shifter here, and we'll get a cool pitch. Let's try something here. Okay, that is really cool. Okay, let's try it. Growl 1. I actually have a main growl already, but we'll use that for something else, I guess. Okay, so we have that already. So create automation here. Let's see, paste that. Okay, we'll do something like that. Let's get the chiptune-y effect here. It'd be freaking dope. Okay, no release, no attack. Little vibrato. Delay. Not sure if we should keep the chord progression going here. Okay, yeah, we might keep the chord progression. Just for that. And then we can sort of cut it sometimes if find it's too much. So yeah, I'll do this. Paste that right there. Okay, there you go. I'll paste that there as well. Just cut that in half, that's a little bit long there. This is at the wrong place. Yeah, a lot of this stuff is. Damn it. I don't know what happened there. That's a bit weird. Hey, thanks, Jizzle. Some dope stuff you just pulled out of your hat right there, mate. Yeah! Oh, yeah. Out of my hat. Yeah, that wouldn't be too bad. Right here, get a little thing like that, pitch bend. Oh yeah, that's reverb there, eh? Oh, I have an idea. I'll do this on the dry wet here. Oh, on the delay as well. Nope. Okay, now more sounds, more weird stuff. Okay, what are we gonna do here? Okay, I'll get the crude wavetable, because that is... Okay, crude is really weird, so... I've made some crazy growls with crude, so... Okay, that's not too bad. Oh! Listen to that! Hold on, attack, right here. Okay, so... Hold on, opposite, just like that. Attack. Yep. Okay, cool, cool. Band pass. Freaking love this wavetable so much. Okay, maybe band reject. Okay, a little distortion on there. A little bending shape, maybe. Okay. Hey, damn. Okay, crude bass. Okay, we're gonna shove that in the sidechain right here. I'm not sure if we should do it up or down, like. Okay, let's do this. Yeah, that's the thing. Okay, yeah, I like it lower like that. So it has a track. Just want to... Oh, damn it. I hate clicking on freaking ozone instead of, like, Maximus. Such a waste of time. Okay, Maximus, let's go. Alright, nice thing right here. Freaking great. Oh, one thing I love doing... Oh, I love doing this. Just one second, I'll pull this out. Okay, desktop. Nope. Okay, I might actually have to... Oh my god, it's something like actually hilarious that I started doing for some reason. New sound, waves. It's some... Where is it? We have to listen to a bunch of stuff. Pretty sure... Is that it? Yes, right on. Okay, so I like putting waves, like water. This part right here is hilarious. So check this out. Just like relatively loud, I'd say. But let's see, is this part better here? Maybe I could. It's a little bit louder. So okay. Go ahead and give that track water. Go sidechain. I just want to hear it itself. Okay. Oh, right here. That's a perfect spot. Okay. Now you just have to compress that. Maybe EQ a little bit. Okay. I don't know if anyone else does this, but like I just thought it's hilarious. There you go. Just like that. Just that. That's my signature right there. Let's see. Just that little part right there. That'd be perfect. Yeah. A, E. That's what I wanted to do, but I don't know if it's gonna work at all. Hey, no. Damn it, what's the bass chord? There you go, D, B. Finally, that's the one. Alright, let's hear that. More water everywhere. Water everywhere. I don't know why I do that, but whatever. There you go. Water. Alright, let's get some real samples in here. Okay, that's a little weird. Oh, pedal to the metal. I could actually use that as real. Oh man. I could actually use this as real freaking sound. Just like, just straight up. Yeah, boy. Finally found the stream. I watched all your videos on YouTube. Great job, bro. Hey, thank you very much. I appreciate that. Thanks for coming by. That's hilarious. Oh man, my brother's gonna laugh because it's actually his old car that this is his old car pretty much. Okay, let's go ahead and EQ this. I'll actually layer sub under there because that would be funny as hell. Okay, little sub bass there. We're almost hitting 2 hours there on the stream. I'd be very happy uploading that onto YouTube if you guys want to check that out later. I can't hear the bass right now, but hey, Jizzle is now hosting me. Thank you, man. I appreciate that. Let's see. Okay, probably an E right here. There you go. Alright, let's hear that. Alright. Oh, I could actually use these vocals as fillers. Okay, I just need to find the right pitch here. Okay, right here. I'm not sure. Probably this. I'll try it out. I'm gonna try it out. Okay. Okay, let's. Hold on. I want to do a pitch drop here with the sub bass, just like a sub drop, pretty much. Hit you up with the host. I gotta sleep, work in a few hours. Good shit, man. All right, see you later, bro. I don't know if you're actually leaving or not. But it'd be a good idea if you're working pretty soon, so yeah. Okay, let's go with a 24 here. And that'll do a sub drop. Yeah, just like that. I don't know what note that is, it's an F2. Alright. Oh man, that's so funny. If I actually leave that there for the official song, that'd be freaking. What the hell? I need to find the perfect spot. There you go, perfect. Oh man. Oh, whoops, that's not well placed at all. Okay, that is perfect. Okay, I have to layer sub under these things right here. Where is that? Right here. Now that's a bit loud, eh? So I have to cut the sub bass and then layer real sub bass under it. So that's how you gotta do it, unfortunately. You want to get it to sound good, you know? Okay, so sub bass. Can't hear it at all. Oh, that's why. Where is it? Sub bass. Maybe I could link this growl one pitch to the sub bass pitch. I like to do that a lot now. It saves automation clips and time. So okay, growl one channel pitch now. There you go, that's how you do it, and you can probably do it here as well. So let's let the crude bass go by right here. Okay, that wouldn't be too bad. Let's just link that here, link the controller, new link, crude bass one. There you go, that's how you do it. Just one thing I have to do. High pass here. Just to prevent clotting up in there. Nice. Yes! Alright, well, I would like to thank everybody for coming by today at the stream. I think it was a really good stream. We were very productive today. This is crazy. Like, haven't been this productive on a stream in a very long time. So I hope you guys enjoyed the stream. And I'll see you guys next time. I'll link you guys to my Twitter if you guys want. So you can follow me around and stuff. Where did I learn all that stuff? The basics on YouTube, and other than that, messing around for sure. You know, just turning knobs and seeing what they do and stuff like that. That's pretty much how I did. So yeah, here's my Twitter, guys. Please follow me on there, as I like to tweet when I stream and stuff. And yeah.